everyone. This is Nancy Shah, Assistant Professor, LG Institute of Pharmacy. I welcome all Sensory students in this e-lecture series. So I welcome to the students to the e-lecture series, which is an initiative taken by LG Institute of Pharmacy for the betterment of students, so that their studies should not get hampered anyway, right? Hope you all are well in this lockdown and you all are healthy and fit. So let's start with the today's lecture, which is on ischemic heart disease. Now students, what is ischemia? So first of all, we should understand the definition of ischemia, right? So basically, ischemic heart disease, how it occurs? It occurs due to any reason, due to any etiological factors which can affect the heart, right? Ischemia means death of cells. So this ischemic conditions can occur when the coronary artery in the heart is getting blocked, right? Now how it gets blocked? Simple, if you take a rubber pipe, right, and if you fold it, right, so it will get clogged, it will get blocked. So what happens? The water will not flow further. Same happens with the heart also. If due to any reason, right, if in the heart, if in the artery, that is coronary artery, right, which is supplying blood to the organs, different organs of the body, if that gets clogged, if that gets blocked due to any reason, right, so what occurs? So the blood to the remaining part of the heart is not getting enough, right, enough supply, right, other organs of the body is not getting enough supply. Means what occurs? There occurs an ischemic condition in that portion, right, which is called as ischemia, right. Now here we are talking about ischemic heart disease. So it is a group of acute or chronic cardiac disabilities, right, resulting from insufficient supply of oxygenated blood to the heart, right. Now usually what happens when the supply to the heart, if it gets blocked, right, if the heart is not getting enough supply, so the tissues, that is the cells, cardiac cells, or what you call myocytes, right, around the heart becomes dead, right, because of not getting sufficient oxygenated blood, right, not getting enough oxygenated blood, which causes a condition called ischemia and which is called as ischemic heart disease. Further, it can be explained that the blood vessels, right, they get narrowed or blocked, right, due to the deposition of cholesterol, right, on walls, right, which causes or which reduces the supply of oxygen, right, and nutrients to the heart, right, heart muscles, and which hampers the proper functioning of the heart, right. Then this can lead to deprived supply, leading to the death in the surrounding cells or in the surrounding tissues of the heart, right. This can lead to ischemia. This can also lead to heart attack, right. So as the heart is pumping, right, which supplies oxygenated blood to various vital organs, as I have told before, right, now any defect in the heart, right, due to any defect, if it impairs the supply of oxygenated blood, right, then this can lead to ischemia. This can lead to eventual failure or death, right, of the tissue. Okay, this can lead to ischemic heart disease. So this is just an overview of ischemia, ischemic heart disease. Now how it occurs? So basically, what is the pathophysiology, right? So in this semester you have to learn about the pathophysiology of any disease, right? Then how it occurs, that is the etiological factors, its causes, right? Then what are the signs and symptoms, and what are the risk factors and complications, right? So focusing on the pathophysiology of ischemic heart disease. So due to any etiological factors, if there occurs injury to the endothelial cell, right, that is the lining of the artery, then this can lead to inflammation and certain immune reactions, right? This can lead to accumulation of lipids in the intima of the arterial wall, right? Why I'm telling intima? Because there is three type of layers in the artery or in any wall, right? That is first interior wall, that is called as intima. Now if there occurs accumulation of lipids in the intima of endothelium of arterial wall, or you can say of endothelium, right, then this causes T lymphocytes and monocytes, right, that becomes as macrophages, right, that infiltrate the area by ingestion or ingesting, right, or they engulf the lipids, right, and die. This can lead to proliferation of smooth vessel cells within the vessel. This can lead to formation of fibrous cap over dead fatty core, and which can lead to erythema formation, right. Now, protrusion of erythema into the lumen of vessel, right, which can lead to narrowing and obstruction. Now, if narrowing and obstruction has occurred, right, and if the cap is thin, the lipid may rupture, right, which can lead to a clot formation, or which can lead to a formation of thrombus, that is, a thrombus is getting developed, right. Now, this thrombus can obstruct the blood flow, and this can lead to sudden cardiac death, which is called as due to myocardial infarction, right. Now, what is the symptoms for that? So, angina is a symptom if there occurs myocardial infarction. So, basically, you have to understand in ischemic heart disease that ischemic heart disease, it can lead to angina, right? That is chest pain, okay? And what are the reason or what is the symptom for that? That is myocardial infarction and erythroma, that is atherosclerosis, right? That is formation of plaque, okay? Now, these are the two different terms you have to understand, that is atherosclerosis. As I've talked in the pathophysiology, that there occurs formation of erythema, right? That's the plaque formation occurs, right? Now, plaque formation means what? It has in it certain kind of macrophages, right? Macrophages, and this macrophages, they engulf lipids, right? Lipids, all the endothelium is made up of lipid wall, right? So they engulf lipids from the intima or the endothelial lining, right, and they obstruct or they form a plaque in the artery, right, that is called as atherosclerosis. Now, if atherosclerosis, which contains the clot formation, okay, in it, that is atherosclerotic plaque with clot, that is thrombotic atherosclerotic plaque, you can say, right, means it has clot formation, it has with some blood with it, right, that is called as atherosclerotic plaque, but with a clot, that is thrombus formation, right. Now, because of this blockage, what occurs? There occurs impaired circulation of blood, right, means oxygenated blood supply is getting hampered, right, which can lead to myocardial infarction. Now, in further next slides or in the next session, we'll study regarding this, but basically focusing on today's session, that is ischemic heart disease. But for this, you need to know that ischemia, in that responsible thing is myocardial infarction and atherosclerosis, right? And due to that, there occurs angina, right? You say you must be saying that heart attack occurs. That is, heart attack means what? That is chest pain, which is nothing but angina. So angina, that is chest pain. Okay. Now, what are the risk factors for ischemic heart disease? So the risk factors are elevated low density lipoprotein, that is LDL, right? Then reduced high density lipoprotein. Okay, always there are two types of lipoproteins, LDL and HDL. Now, LDL, that is, you can say a bad lipoprotein or bad cholesterol, right? And HDL, that is high density lipoprotein, you can say a good good cholesterol or good lipoprotein, right? Now, whenever in the body, if there occurs the amount or if there occurs raised levels of LDL, right? If there occurs deposition of LDL and if there is raised level of LDL, means it is a dangerous condition, right? It can lead to plaque formation, okay? And if there is reduced HDL, that is also dangerous. So, which should be in the proportionate amount. So, if HDL is increasing, that is good sign. But if LDL is increasing, that is a bad sign, right? So, in ischemic heart disease, what occurs? So there is increased level of LDL and decreased level of HDL, right? Then the next risk factor is family history of premature myocardial infarction or sudden death, right? Then due to cigarette smoking also, there occurs damage to the endothelium, endothelial lining, right? Then hypertension, it can also lead to ischemic heart disease, diabetes mellitus, right? Then it is found that males, which is above 45 years of age, and females, which is nearly above 55 years of age, they are more prone to ischemic heart disease, right? 55 years of age women, that is postmenopausal women, okay? Then obesity. Then the next other risk factors are sedentary lifestyle, right? Then hypertriglyceridemia, then small LDL particles, right? That is increased lipoprotein concentration, increased serum homocysteine concentration, then abnormalities in coagulation factors, right? This is an important risk factor, right? Then if there is any type of chronic infection or inflammation, then this can all lead to ischemic heart disease. The next is the signs and symptoms. So the first sign of ischemia is that severe chest pain, okay, that is in the form of angina pectoris. As I have told, that chest pain, that is nothing but angina, right? In doctor's term, it is called as angina, okay? So the main symptom for the angina is pain, which is radiating from chest to lower, to left arm, to jaw, or to back also, right? Then this may be aggravated by exercise, right? By chronic exercise, this sign can be aggravated or it can be increased, right? Then the second risk factor, second signs and symptoms is if a patient is anemic, then if a patient is having, is obese, right? That is obesity. Then diabetes, thyroid, or peripheral vascular disease. Peripheral vascular disease means if there occurs any sort of clot formation, right? If there is improper circulation of blood into the joints, right? That is peripheral vascular disease, right? That is your hands, legs, right? Then this can lead to peripheral vascular disease. Then next symptoms are, that is feeling tight, right? Pressure, crushing, squeezing, right? Then irregular or rapid pulse if found, right? Then shortness of breath, okay? And shortness of breath that can occur, right? After lying down for a while. Then cough, fatigue, weakness, faintness, right? Then decreased alertness or concentration, then decreased urine output, excessive urination at night, overall swelling, breathing difficulty, all these are signs and symptoms of ischemic heart disease. The next is complications of ischemic heart disease. So what are the complications? As I have told, that due to ischemia, there are chances of occurring angina, that is chest pain, which can lead to heart attack, heart failure, or abnormal heart rhythm, that is called arrhythmia. Okay, so students, I hope that you have much known knowledge regarding ischemic heart disease. You must have learned the overview regarding the definition of ischemic heart disease, the pathophysiology, signs and symptoms, the complications, the risk factors, right? All this you need to know, right? Then in my next lecture, I'll be making you aware regarding myocardial infarction and angina, okay? And also atherosclerosis, right? So till then, these are the important questions you need to know regarding ischemic heart disease, okay? So thank you so much. And for more such lectures, please subscribe our channel, YouTube channel, that is Pharma Ignite, right? Please like and subscribe, okay? Thank you.